we got for Anarchy and GIF?
Yeah, a bunch of Son of Anarchy shit,
there
bro.
There we go. Perfect. Fucking...
Perfecto.
It's the fucking... Fucking Joker.
Heath.
It's the Heath Leather Ledger Joker.
Good.
Heath Leather. That's the
Heath
one.
Heath Leather Ledger.
Heath Leatherface.
Heath Leatherface.
Playing Joker.
He's both a serial killer and a candy bar.
Nice. Yeah, that's a weird ass candy bar too.
Yeah, it is.
I think the best candy bar is the Whatchamacallit.
Yeah. 100 grand
not
bar.
The best.
Sorry.
The weird. It fits its name. It's a Whatchamacallit.
Yeah. Sure. Shit. Zero bar. It's a.
Yeah.
It's a Snickers with white chocolate.
Yeah. I like them. There's a bunch of candy bars I like that have peanuts fucking just jammed around them. Like payday. Paydays look fucking great until they just fucking.
The peanuts are the best part.
No, everything looks so good until they just fucking dunk it in peanuts, and I'm like, oh, that's where you lost me.
Peanuts have their time, but yeah, like ones that are just, I get, yeah, it's the.
I eat Snickers just because there's so much other shit.
Caramel and fucking.
Yeah, and the chocolate and all that.
Oh man, yeah, Snickers are good. Snickers are good as fuck. We just want to point out Snickers are good as fuck. And M&M's.
Fuck M&M's.
They aight.
Alright.
Fuck M&M's. They aight.
They ain't no hot shit, though.
I mean, they alright.
They alright.
M&M's alright.
M&M's alright.
And with that, welcome.
The M&M or just the best? Okay.
I don't think you're talking loud enough.
Welcome.
There you go.
To the Bored Nerds Hour.
You just have to yell at the podcast.
I'm Levi, this is Lee. That's Joey, that's Sydney.
No, I'm not.
She said she's not. She's there. Look at her. She's laying down halfway.
No,
she forgot her pillow at my house.
I know! I wanted it, and then I was like, no!
You left your pillow, and he left his hat. His, like, beanie.
I did. I was like, that thing.
I was sitting there, like, cleaning up. I was like, listen, I was like, that's a whole pillow. That's a whole pillow they left here.
Those
cigarettes still gone.
Oh, man.
I don't know what happened.
What is playing behind us?
What?
Is that Casey falling over? It is.
It is.
She's
sick.
It's on Facebook.
Let me see if I can get that bigger. I can move it up there.
There you go.
I can't make it any bigger than that.
Oh, yeah. What is this thing? No one ever told me what it was.
What?
That same day where Casey put it, it says, this infamous piece of garbage that we had to forego a beautiful plush shark and nipple fans just to be graced with this functional pointless existence.
It was a disc cleaner.
Yeah.
We were talking about that earlier.
Me, him, and Chase went to Dave and Buster's and we won a shitload of tickets and we saw fucking little plush sharks and all this cool stuff.
Why
it was Chase's birthday and he was like, dude, let me get that from Fallout 3. And we're like, look at all this other stuff you get. It's like, nah, man, come on. I'm like, all right, get home. Didn't even work. He ended up buying a new Fallout 3. It's like, you took away that plush shark, those little fans. Hang on to your nipples.
Yeah.
All right, let's get this show on the road because we got a bunch of crap to talk about.
So much crap.
Over our data a third time.
First thing on the list is Joey and Sydney's internet still out.
Yeah.
We're about to go over our data a third time.
Ugh.
Yeah.
Make sure you on that.
That's what reminded me was when he said that day. I was like, oh yeah, they still don't have internet.
Yeah.
It's
and
been
for
how
a week.
No!
A week and a day. Or not last Thursday.
Yeah.
Ooh, and went with.
No, 2 days.
Like all of our things primarily being ran by internet. That's.
Yeah.
Pretty fucking rough.
Like,
yeah, it also sucks.
Dick
it happened for that.
Yeah.
You can only play Casey's games.
Yeah, you can only play Casey's games. And some 360 games.
Yeah, that's like, you can only play Casey's games, which is about a 50-50 split. I can't play anything.
Right.
Yeah, that's true. That's
true. But you can play all the free stuff.
Yeah, the free stuff.
No, free stuff doesn't work for me.
No?
No.
Some of them do, some of them don't.
Yeah,
like, I forget what it is, man.
What is the number for
there's
the
some
Wi-Fi?
That do
it,
some
though. The last 3 years.
627.
Is it 627?
Maybe I'll let you join this
no.
time.
Yeah, the internet was in the process of going down last time.
Yeah.
Yay!
Quick story about internet then. Went out, called. They were like, we think it might be an outage. You'll get a call if the outage is fixed. If not, we put a ticket for somebody to come on Wednesday. It's like, all right, that's almost a week away, but all right. And then got around to Wednesday. We actually got a call.
It was Tuesday.
Yeah. Tuesday, we got an automated call, and they were like, yeah, we'll come between 8 and 12. And I was like, all right, cool. So we didn't go to work.
Called out of work.
Just are you just trying to make the story more dramatic?
Well, so we called out, used a sick day. We
called out of work, used our last sick day.
That was on you. So, and then it was around 12:15, nobody showed up, so we called again. And they're like, yeah, there's an outage. And so when you get an outage, it cancels the,
it canceled
our ticket for that guy to come out. So he just didn't come out. And then we called them three to four times that day. And they were like, they just kept giving us like hours. They were like, yeah, there's an outage. The estimate time is going to be fixed is like 2. We waited till like 2:30, call them again. And they're like, yeah, it'll be 5. Call them again and it'll be 7. Did that until about 11 o'clock and I didn't want to call them back at 11. So I was like, fuck it. So we went to bed. And then I called the lady the next day when we got back from my mom's. And it was like 6 or 7 when we got back from my mom's. I used to fuck with the internet that day. And lady was like, yeah, that outage got fixed yesterday morning, or this morning. And I was like, I still don't have internet. It's been a week now. So she made a ticket for a guy to come out, but she also made it. She said she made it like a priority ticket since we haven't had internet for a week. So I was hoping he would have came out yesterday. Watch him come today while we're not home.
Yeah.
But...
or tomorrow when we're not
she
home.
Said the
or
ticket
the next day when
yeah
we're not home.
Well, she said the ticket is for Monday, but that was like the when they give you the ticket, that's like the latest they'll come.
Yeah. But we
so.
Still won't be home.
Yeah,
well, until after 4 o'clock. So
you
so
gonna get any discount for having anything
yeah.
working for
yeah,
yeah
I
you can call
always
them tell
call them and bitch them out and they discount
yeah.
us for the time that we don't
yeah I was gonna
it.
Say if you yell at Windstream loud enough they will just fucking roll over. That was the way. That was always our solution when we were living there. It was just yell at Windstream enough, and they give in, and then they punch you in the fucking back of the head later.
Yeah.
They always get each back. All right, so
that's
get started on the shiz
on this wonderful news. I don't need that open anymore. So Final Fantasy 14. The MMO.
The crazy MMO.
Getting a Netflix series. It's out in Japan already.
I believe it. Fuck you, Japan, getting all the cool shit.
But it's coming later this year.
Well, they're way ahead, so.
Later.
Yeah, they didn't tell us about 9/11. What the fuck?
Yeah, so coming later this year, you got Final Fantasy 14 TV series.
Which is probably going to be just okay.
It'll be okay, I'm sure.
It'll probably look really pretty.
Yeah. Mad Gax filed for bankruptcy.
So if you want any terrible third, okay.
Get some good arcade sticks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some were okay.
Some third party controllers, the main ones.
Yeah.
When they were, especially when they started off, God, they were bad.
It was the ones you always pawned off on a person that came over. Like, hey, buddy, you get to use this one. I get the real one.
Yeah, it never feels right. You know, they've gotten better over time, but it just sucks they're going to.
Yeah. They said it was mainly. They've been doing bad in the past few weeks, and then they're part of some game or something. They have, and it did really poorly. I forgot who they had stops in.
Do you have something I could use from my iPad?
You got the old wide?
I told him to pack it, and he didn't.
I told you. I thought it was
I might have a car charger somewhere. That's the closest I got, though. Star Wars Celebration is going on, which is the real reason I have this on here. Because there ain't no way they're announcing that. But it says right here, Obi-Wan Kenobi solo movie could get announced at Star Wars Celebration. I highly doubt that.
Did you hear about the Star Wars teaser that some few people got to see?
Nuh-uh.
They said it was only a very short clip, but only certain people got to go in the cinema and see, like, they said Rey was moving some rocks, lighting her rocks, like she was doing some training. And they posted something on their Twitter where it was fucking Luke on her back like Yoda. He was just like, it was just off camera, just Mark Hamill.
Oh, gosh. Sounds like Mark Hamill. But Star Wars Celebration is going on, so I'm sure news will come out that we don't cover because it's going on at the same time. I'm putting this over here. cover up fucking John Oliver and Bill Moore's face. Rocket League is getting a Fate of the Furious. They're getting Dom's fucking car.
From the first one.
All right, that's cool.
Also in here, I think is Hot Wheels DLC.
Yeah.
Somewhere. So Rocket League continuing to pump out the buy shit stuff.
Of course, free to play. You gotta pump it.
Yep.
Out.
Oh. That's not free to play.
No. Yeah.
It's $20.
Oh. That's $20.
Yeah.
It's worth it.
$20. I got it.
You got it, Michigan.
For Honor. Now, this is in response to the fact that For Honor is currently has a strike going on with players.
The people that are still playing, and then there's half of them that probably won't go back to it.
Going on in 2 days, I believe.
2 days of boycott. Could have fooled me. No one's playing that game anyway.
Yeah.
And the only thing this is addressing, I think, is server issues.
Fuck!
Yeah.
Some I know what else to do with the gear.
They're increasing your steal. How much fucking money you get.
It would have took, like, 2.5 years of gameplay to get everything for all the characters before then.
But you're not supposed to play all the characters. You're only supposed to play one or two.
Yeah, but
maybe don't have fucking 9 characters if you're only supposed to play one or two. And two more coming out on DLC soon, and 6 more after that.
And then being like, yeah, you just gotta play the game every day, 10 hours a day for 2 years, and you'll have everything, guys.
That's like Overwatch, though.
Yeah, right? There are also problems because I don't have this anywhere.
I work for 10-hour days.
But there was a tournament going on up in old Canada. Found out because of Wooly.
What the
Wooly
fuck
from
is old
fucking
Canada?
Best friends. It's just Canada.
Just Canada.
But
old,
they were
like
having
old
a four honor tournament.
Oh.
And servers were down.
Oh, who could have guessed
it? Which meant no tournament.
That sounds like Master Chief Collection. But you didn't have none of those.
Because it's online only, and you can't play nothing but single player. And you can only play a little bit of that. You can't even play all of that.
Nope.
So, For Honor continuing to suck the dick out of everything.
I like this next one.
Yeah. Oculus co-founder Palmer Luckey is leaving Oculus. This is due to the controversy with the fact that he created they say he created the VR stuff while he was working at his last company.
Mm. Well, that actually got solved for what? They got the lawsuit. They said, no, he didn't steal anything,
yeah.
But he broke the no, don't tell anyone agreement.
No, yeah.
Yeah,
NDA.
Yeah, and then he broke that, so they had to pay out $500 million.
Yeah.
But he sold it for $2.3 billion.
So
yeah,
so it's like, fucking drop in the bucket.
Yeah.
But another reasons, I don't know if you have it on here, is he donated $10,000 to a Trump support group.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
And people were not happy about it. Especially when he is part of Facebook.
He's partnered with Facebook is the other thing down here.
They own Oculus.
Yeah.
I forgot about that.
So, negative media. He apologized right after it, but damn, it was already done.
Yeah. So, good luck, Palmer Luckey. Go on and make something crazy. I'm sure you will. Just don't
make another magazine cover like the last one.
Yeah. SpaceX.
Where's the shoes?
Speaking also of fucking crazy science people.
Fucking Elon.
Elon Musk's SpaceX successfully landed their reused rocket.
Which is big.
Orbital rocket, not just a rocket.
Yeah.
Because it launched something into orbit. Other companies have launched stuff straight up, but not into circling the planet. Which is massive news because all the cost is in the first time you use it, and it's a quarter of the amount of money to use it the second time.
It can make it a lot more available.
This is why they are saying 2030 for fucking
commercial trips to space.
Trips to Mars and stuff.
Right.
Like commercial trips to space, just go into orbit and shit.
They've got their first commercial trip to space next year. Taking 2 people around the moon.
So that's going to take a while and going to cost, definitely assume, an absurd amount of money.
Yep. Now, this next one is not as innovative, but just as important. Club Penguin is officially gone.
It's officially gone.
We announced that it was leaving. It is gone now. It's been gone for a couple days.
Four.
They do have a mobile app, but it's not the same.
It's not even close, I imagine.
It's not Club Penguin.
Goddamn, I don't even know. Right. I'm reading ahead, but
all right. We already got touched on.
Yeah, I touched on.
Or at least Facebook as well.
Yeah, he left. He had stepped up and everything.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Is it what he did?
Yeah.
Okay.
They pretty much probably
forced
him
out,
like,
kind of thing.
We don't need this negative media. Get
yeah.
out.
Yeah.
Spike from Buffy. You guys remember Buffy the Vampire Slayer?
I read that too quickly earlier. I thought that said Bully. And then I thought of the Bully show that was on MTV.
I thought of the game.
Yeah, that's it.
I can't get it to work on this to, like, pull it up.
Yeah.
But he's dressed as Vegeta. He's got the, like, fucking logo on his shirt. Now, fun thing about him. Do you know what his ties are to Dragon Ball?
No.
He was Piccolo in the Dragon Ball Evolution movie.
Whew.
And he hated that it came out like a huge piece of shit. Because he loves Dragon Ball.
Damn. Everybody loves Dragon Ball.
And I just think that that's, And, like, in this thing where they were interviewing him for the picture, and it's like, I am fucking so sorry that turned out the way it did. That was never part of the plan.
Yeah, it's like, I just wanted to make it cool.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's what everybody wants to do, but then some people...
Then they just...
You try too hard, and it just flops. God damn it, why is this even
this
a thing?
One,
who cares?
Most of New Jersey is a Hanzo main. Continuing the stereotype that Jersey's fucking terrible.
Fuck you, Jersey. Play someone actually good.
Yeah. Hey, I'm Mr. Cryptic.
Hello.
Man,
Hanzo's not that bad.
Hanzo's not that bad.
No.
Hanzo's just becoming the meme person.
It's
for
just the meme,
the,
yeah.
That's a sniper guy, right?
Yeah.
The bow.
Yeah.
He can be useful on the team. It's between that and Genji and McCree.
Yeah,
there's just too many people that want to play the offensive character,
yeah.
And not enough that want to do support
stuff. Teamwork, yeah.
Teamwork. They should just go. If you don't want to play teamwork, just go fucking 1v1 stuff.
Stop playing that much.
Get out of here.
Nope.
Oh god, how do I?
Oh man.
Oh, we can talk about. I forgot. Might as well hit it before you get on this.
Yeah, you do that while I close out of this.
The first episode of Attack on Titan 2, Season 2, started today.
Yeah.
What?
Yep. I'm watching on Crunchyroll right now.
Shit!
So...
I can't because I have no fucking internet.
And I got Crunchyroll. We can sit and watch a 30-minute episode of Attack on Titan.
We'll be coming over every week.
The teaser was pretty cool. It just showed Eren as a Titan... all fucked up, and he's like, I'm gonna kill all the Titans.
God damn it. Oh, man. Megan's great idea of, hey, do a cartwheel.
Yeah.
He's like, what?
I executed a perfect cartwheel.
Yeah.
Speaking of Four Honor tournaments, the Executioner, or the Peacekeeper, the Assassin class from the Knights is banned.
For being too OP.
Because she's OP as fuck.
She just grabs
and
stabs.
Poison.
Yeah. You just
that
grab
side
her and shank him.
And plus, she's so fast.
Yeah.
That's the big deal.
Just running out the clock.
Yeah.
Jordan
next
Peele.
Up, this is a little bit of anime
this is
news.
No more anime stuff.
Jordan Peele from Key and Peele from Mad TV from Get Out.
Get Out, which did outrageously good.
Did wonderful. Is in talks to do Akira live action.
They actually are reaching out to him to produce it.
Which is interesting.
Well, he was like, what was the status? Like, he's the first African-American
to
make $500 million on an opening movie. Like, their first movie.
Yeah, on their first opening movie, yeah.
Which is a fucking accomplishment no matter what.
Yeah, even if you've, you know.
Yeah, regardless.
If you've been in the business for a while, it's like, that's a good selling. First movie, boom.
Especially coming from straight out of Mad TV.
A guy who dressed up like Obama.
Yeah.
Damn it, yeah.
North Carolina undid their bathroom thing. I just wanted to touch on this because it's funny. The only reason they did it was because the NCAA said they wouldn't look at them for any future tournaments for sporting events.
Yeah.
So
good.
So they undid their bathroom bill.
Good.
And now you can potty wherever the fuck you want.
Good.
As long as it's not in the fucking floor.
Nice.
Because you'll get people staring at you if you pee in the floor no matter what bathroom you're in.
But I relate to an animal, so I'm just gonna go on the floor.
Yeah, get out of here. Bathrooms are for people.
I was thinking of little Nicky I watched that the other day. He's just shitting out on the sidewalk. It's like, it's okay for me to use the bathroom out here. You have to use a bathroom. Injustice 2.
Yeah.
Injustice 2, we got new Captain Cold, Scarecrow, and Bane.
Oh, man. He's going to be backbreaking the shit out of Batman.
He kind
of
does. He kind of just is a big... He's a grappler. Imagine that. Bane's a grappler. And he's just a backbreaker machine.
Nice.
Captain Cold looks cool.
Captain Cold does look cool.
No
is
pun
it,
intended.
Is it,
I want Mr. Mr. Freeze.
Oh,
Freeze.
The rumor is that there's going to be a skin for him that's just Mr. Freeze.
Nice. That's going to be awesome.
But it won't be Arnold, Mr. Freeze.
I want it to be Arnold.
You need to chill.
Just to come in.
What kills the dinosaurs? The Ice Age.
I would buy a
God, those lines are so dumb, but so good.
That was the one part that made that fucking movie tolerable.
Yeah.
It was Arnold just pun after pun.
Yeah. It's pretty bad.
Miyazaki says Dark Souls is done for now.
Oh, no. DLC for Dark Souls
3. DLC for Dark Souls 3 is out.
Yeah, the Ring City.
The Ring City.
I've seen a lot
Harpies
of...
did a great thing with it.
Oh, yeah. I got that in here.
They did their... Curly Frost, like if you need help in the Ring City, you know it's got your ass Solaire on it.
Yeah, it's got it's got a big old Solaire's great.
So
I've seen some Twitch fails of this.
Oh yeah,
and it's of everyone hitting the same spot, and there's one point, slight spoilers, where things come out of the ground and you get hit with fucking 500 arrows.
Oh,
Jesus!
God.
And everyone reacts the exact same way.
Like Jesus fuck.
And the first one was like a girl, and she's like. What just happened? The second one was Max from fucking is Maximilian.
Was he just like,
that's bullshit. Like, oh my god!
Jeez.
And there was one guy in there that rolled out of the way and didn't die from that. But they had fucking pumped all their points into health. Every single one of them that I was looking at, their health bars were going across the screen. It was just draining the health bars.
Those type of games when you hit. Like the soft cap on skills, you might as well invest in like health or something.
But it was just like, it was amazing how much damage they fucking did.
Yeah.
But Dark Souls, go play that.
Good game.
Man, let's skip on that next one.
Man.
We have like a whole like 15 minutes section.
Yeah, we got a whole bunch of Destiny we got to talk about. Little music stuff. Boxcar Racer, their album, that was the side project from Liquid I2. Is getting re-released on vinyl.
Oh.
Levi, tell your wife I had to let my DS connect to it.
I don't know if...
I thought you said wife. I was like...
I know, I don't have a wife.
Waifu.
We'll do a whole bunch of Destiny here at one time.
Joss Whedon, the
director for The Avengers, first Avengers movie, said to me in talks for directing Batgirl.
Which is going to be interesting, and they already said it's going to have a lot of people from... the DC universe, like Flash, and yada.
They need something lighthearted in DC. They really do. Flash is making jokes in the Justice League trailer, which is also on here.
Which, I don't know if you have it on here. Stated to be about a 3-hour long movie, Justice League.
Yep.
They gotta get in those backstories, all them characters.
So, be prepared when you go there.
Yeah.
Bring a monster or something.
Bring a monster and then another can to pee in. Because you're going to be there for a while. More Destiny. Andromeda's getting a patch. It's got a patch.
Is it a soft patch?
It's just...
Like, not to do with the animation.
No, it's not animation stuff. It's just... it was just... I think it was mostly for multiplayer stuff. Because people were reporting that it was having real connectivity and lag issues. I wasn't running into any of that, and I don't by any means have the best internet around, but I wasn't having any of that problem.
You
just
have internet.
It's true. Reboot is getting a reboot.
God.
It's live action.
Ugh.
And looks like garbage.
Yeah,
that picture says it all.
That's old reboot.
Yeah.
Oh, God, I'll show me a new one.
So, you look at that.
Those are monsters. Look like Sims.
And then, if this loads.
Monsters.
It's just some fucking kids sitting at a table.
Yeah.
And one's got a banana.
And one's got half a banana.
What's
that?
Is that
like
a pizza?
No.
Pizza or something?
No, that's like a tablet.
Like that?
Oh, God.
Ain't no way that's a tablet.
Alright.
Get out of here. I hate... This is the one problem with comicbook.com. This and game trailers or whatever.
Yeah, they just start playing...
Fucking start playing goddamn music.
Are they...
Cut that out.
Or they do like the video form of what you're about to read.
Yeah. Just like, let me read it. Let me read the fucking article.
Oh, the Power Rangers movie out too.
Oh yeah, yeah. I also said he watched it.
Said it was I've heard.
Wasn't bad.
I've heard. Yeah, it's decent.
Yeah.
We got Disney upcoming schedule, which is important because it's got Star Wars and Marvel on it now.
Oh.
So let me just mute this tab before we go into here.
Just.
Preemptively. But we've got Beauty and the Beast just came out. Born in China.
Got really
coming out.
Review.
Yeah, yeah.
Spring.
The
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Guardians of the Galaxy right after that.
Cars.
And then
Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah.
Then Cars 3.
Yeah. I couldn't read those.
Untitled Fairy Tale, which I don't know what other fucking Disney fairy tale they're going to do next.
Little Mermaid again?
Yeah, maybe.
Fall?
Little Mermaid.
That's
Thor Ragnarok, which should be fun because
it's already
just,
everywhere.
It's just Thor and the Hulk buddying around.
We'll get you in a little bit. Get out of here with your ads.
Yeah. Coco. I don't know what that's. Oh, it's about a little Mexican boy plays guitar.
That's what it is.
I remember seeing that. That looks cute.
Oh,
yeah. This right here, this grayed out square that you guys can't see because it's up on our screen, is Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Nice.
And it's going to be dealing with online gaming.
No.
So hopefully they'll walk into Call of Duty and they'll just be called a bunch of racial slurs. Speaking of that, bad segue, Black Panther's coming out before that.
Going to be probably pretty good.
Yeah, Black Panther will be pretty good. That cast is all-star and fucking phenomenal.
He was great in Avengers.
Yep. Yeah. A Wrinkle in Time, which is an old fucking story. I guess they're doing a live-action version of that. Avengers, Infinity War, Han Solo, Star Wars. This is getting towards the end of 2017.
And then Incredibles is like... Is that going to be at the end of 2017 or the very beginning of 2018?
It looks like it's the end. It's probably their Christmas release. That Star Wars and Avengers.
Yeah, because the next one says summer of 2018.
Yeah.
So.
Fuck's that movie? Something versus the Wasp.
It's Ant-Man and the Wasp.
Oh, God.
We're getting a new Ant-Man movie.
God, there's so many Marvel movies.
There's so many comic books, guys.
I thought this was going to die off, like, God, so long ago.
Yeah, me too. I honestly didn't think it would last.
But it is.
But the Avengers was really good.
Avengers was super good.
And that's what,
but now
that's
it's getting to where there's so many that you just don't want him, like...
Yeah.
You gotta wait to
with,
Netflix.
Doctor Strange.
Good movie.
Yeah.
That was alright.
Like, I haven't watched that one. I just feel like people are just gonna start going to the ones that they want to see now.
Yeah. It's gonna be character like allegiance.
Yeah.
They're gonna like release. They should release a big old Marvel disc thing. It's got like a shitload of movies.
It's got like
80
fucking movies because that's how.
Yeah. It's gonna be like an $80 movie like they did with Star Wars or like Harry Potter.
That'd be fine. It's like get all these movies.
Some other untitled thing that I can't read because it's too terrible to. Terribly blurry. Mulan live action.
Yeah.
Which isn't going to be a musical. It's just going to be a war movie.
Nice.
And it's going to be an all-Asian cast.
Yeah.
Finally.
Yeah, finally.
Is it going to have Matt Damon in it? Like the
Man,
Great Wall?
I hope so. Matt Damon and Tom Cruise and Keanu Reeves are three top Asian actors.
Yeah,
what about John Wayne?
John Wayne.
We'll bring him back from
playing
the dead.
Playing Genghis Khan.
Oh, man. Go watch The Conqueror.
Go watch The Conqueror.
Jesus.
There's not a single Asian person in that movie.
Nope.
It's just white dudes dressed as Asian people. Gigantic, which is about some lady who controls a giant lady.
Yeah.
Or something.
Oh, yeah. Controls a giant lady.
Mary Poppins Returns. A sequel to Mary Poppins after 70 years.
I was going to say, that movie's old.
And then Captain Marvel.
Is that lady even still alive?
Winter of 2019.
Is that lady even still alive that played?
No.
Mary Poppins, I was about to say.
No
way.
I think she died in like 2013.
Something like that.
Who?
Who played
Mary
Poppins?
She's still alive. She's the one that did the Princess Diaries.
Does she?
I don't know.
She's old. Good for you.
Why are you tagging me photos?
Alright, well.
It was this.
We can kind of skip that.
Yeah, so there's Wreck-It Ralph. Cast is going to be, or it's going to be fucked. It'll be Wreck-It Ralph. It'll be fun.
Yeah.
Here's another fun Andrews. One.
That's what her name is.
Report is that Call of Duty, the next one, will be Call of Duty World War II as the title.
That's a good title.
It's as good a title as Battlefield 1.
Yeah.
Wait, is it World at War 2 or is it?
No, World War 2.
Oh, okay. Say, you don't feel to buy that game, you should have made it.
World at War 2. Yeah.
Man, they don't know what to do.
Yeah, dude. Like, I want not fucking cyber future for Call of Duty anymore.
Yeah.
I want just ahead of
where we are. Or make it something
that's
super futuristic, like. Don't just make it guns and you can boost
guns
the jetpack.
Yeah.
In
ATW, we're gonna have 4 1-year-olds tomorrow.
4 1-year-olds?
Mm-hmm.
Jeez. It's crazy.
It's crazy this world we're living.
Which
Call of Duty is this one now? Is this
like 40?
No, not like who's the production.
Oh, I don't know who this is.
Is this Treyarch? Treyarch does Black Ops.
Treyarch does Black Ops.
Infinity War does the warfare.
Sledgehammer.
Sledgehammer. Yeah. Sledgehammer makes good maps.
Yeah.
I'll give them that. They made good Halo maps.
Yeah.
I'll be interested to see what they do with something that's not future.
Yeah.
It should be fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A little DC TV show news. Flash is getting a new costume. I gotta mute this fucking thing too.
Sorry.
He's adding some gold, making it look a little bit more like comic book Flash. It's not. Yes, it's actually coming together. That show is decent.
Yeah, that show
was
pretty good.
Put anything about that in here?
What the
bottom right?
Oh, Ghost in the Shell. There. Yeah. I think I did. I think I saved the reviews at the time when I had taken them. But yeah, we can talk about Ghost in the Shell. So that came out.
It's the most well-received anime adaptation.
Yeah.
Wait, that movie's out, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
It's played by Scarlett
Johansson. Yeah, Scarlett Johansson. I believe the ratings have dropped as more views came in, though. I'm going to check real quick.
It was sitting at like 68% on Rotten Tomatoes and 70% on Metacritic.
We are
41.
It's come down a little since the initial reviews. It is at a 41% on Rotten Tomatoes.
6.8 out of 10
on IGN.
And 2 out of 4 on
That's Rotten not bad for...
Yeah, Roger Ebert. He's a fucking reviewer.
I would say 6.8 for IGN. That's not bad for a anime adaptation.
Yeah. But one thing I heard about is, like, they said she tries to put life into this boring plot, and I'm like...
It's like, no, you don't know ghosts. You don't know ghosts in the show, that's the thing.
Yeah.
It's not her fault that the pacing and everything might be bad in the movie. But,
yeah, they just get told that out.
They always.
It does look hard it looked cool, though, the trailers.
Yeah,
stuff.
Definitely. That and, this, I don't have this in here, but a new trailer came out for Valerian and the City of a Thousand Worlds or whatever.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
another sci fi movie kind of thing. It's made by the guy who made The Fifth Element.
Oh,
and, looks pretty good. Still looks a lot like Mass Effect. So
doesn't surprise me.
So I mean, I'm sure that'll be fun. Jason David Frank was ejected from Power Rangers premiere.
Wait, isn't that?
That's the Green Ranger. That's
the original. Yeah.
Yeah.
Why?
I didn't actually. Most of these I don't click on.
Were they like, no, you're
mute that tab.
And mute that tab. I hate that. He had a camera in there.
Oh. Because he wanted to film like people's reactions.
He wanted to film people's reactions to cameos.
Oh, and they thought he was going in there.
Yeah,
to
record
okay.
it. It's like, I've been a fucking Power Ranger. Get out of
He's
here.
The
Power
Ranger, Ranger when you fucking list Power Rangers.
Also, speaking of Power Rangers, that Red Ranger that stabbed the dude got
from,
a six...
From fucking Jungle Fury or whatever.
Yeah, whichever it was.
Got 6 years.
Nice.
6 years?
Yep.
He stabbed him.
He stabbed him
with a sword.
He killed him.
Yep.
Sure, 6 years. He'll be back.
He'll be back.
Power Ranger in the bow. apparently they're talking about pulling Spider-Man early from Marvel Cinematic Universe. Because he's supposed to have two standalone movies.
Yeah.
But they have the Venom movie that they're working on that's supposed to be coming out this year. And apparently they think they need Spider-Man back.
Well, because it'd be weird. They might have to make another one, another Spider-Man for the Venom because it's different from them. And it's just a big old confusing
Listen, life. Listen, Sony. Just give your characters.
Yeah.
Just give them. They'll do so much better of a job than you ever will. Have you seen Fantastic Four?
No. You don't want to.
No.
No. Even the old one was...
It was fun, at least.
Yeah.
The newest one was just boring.
Yeah.
But yeah, apparently they're feeling this Venom movie.
Huh? It should be good. Venom's cool. And Carnage gonna be in?
Yeah.
So... They better do it right.
What they should do is have him be chasing down Spider-Man the entire time and have it be Ben Reilly. Have it be Scarlet Spider.
Oh, shit. Dun, dun, dun.
You could even get the same actor because they're fucking clones.
We could.
And then we get to do the Clone Saga, which is a nightmare, and I want to see them try to do it on screen. They should really just do Spider-Verse. Everyone knows fucking Spider-Man.
Yeah.
You could do some fun stuff.
Bring back Toby.
In Spider-Verse, they talk about one that looks like Seabiscuit and Major Garfield.
Yeah.
It's like how they word it.
Rocket League
is getting, I forgot to scroll on this one. Maybe coming to the Switch. They're talking about it, which is cool.
That's a good Switch game.
That's a good Switch game.
Yeah, it would. It'd make it some more money.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the thing. Is like Rocket League was the most downloaded game.
2016. Yeah.
And the game came out in 2014.
Yeah.
Like, there's put it out on the Switch, you're gonna sell as many consoles as they have consoles out there.
It's even better for
and
Switch.
And you go get wrecked online though.
Yeah.
The Switch is the perfect type of platform for that kind
exactly.
of game.
Exactly.
At least almost like a Nintendo game, to be honest.
It does. It's not high maintenance as far as visuals go.
Yeah.
And it's just good old family
fun. Yeah.
Until you get Jab starts going. Talking shit.
Yeah.
Somebody has the record for longest glide in Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
22 minutes.
22 minutes.
Where the fuck did they jump from?
I have no clue.
How'd their stamina last?
They had to eat fucking items that recovered stamina.
Oh my god.
They ate a shit ton of stuff is what the article said. 22-minute glide. Absolutely, absolutely bonkers.
You good?
That's nuts. That's too much. Good
idea.
The flowers.
The flowers?
Cool. On top of there being... Like, we announced last podcast that episode Gladio is out. Or about to come out. It's out now. We got a trailer for Promptos. A teaser trailer for Promptos episode of DLC.
Nice.
Somber
is the report from GamerRant.
GamerRant ain't bad.
Icing people,
probably.
You get to see his like happy-go-lucky attitude.
Yeah.
He's just fucking.
I want fat just, Prompto. Is what I want.
Oh man,
just fat Prompto from before, from before all of it. But yeah, so I mean, I think if you played the game, you figured when they announced episode Gladio. That they were going to do the others because of certain plot things that happen in the fucking game.
Oh, man.
But,
big things are coming.
Big things are coming.
Man, I like how, like, we're getting one in like, every year now.
Yeah. Yep, it's going to be fucking dope. Pacific Rim is wrapped filming. We just got Kong. Godzilla 2 is set to come out next year.
Kong was really good.
Yeah.
That's what everyone... That's a lot of what I've heard. Kong's really
Jay
good.
Said it was
they
really
took
good.
A totally different, like, turn versus the one with the Jack Black movie.
I think really I refer really to it as
the Jack Black Kong.
Yeah.
It's Peter Jackson.
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody's
Jack
like, Jack Black. Because I was like,
I
why is he in here?
Yeah.
You remember Jack Black more than you do Kong in that fucking
you
movie.
Do.
Yeah, you do.
Jack Black is the star of that movie over a fucking 50-foot gorilla.
Oh, fuck. There's something for Sydney down there.
Right. Oh, yeah. What? Over 7,000 Pokemon Sun and Moon players were banned from online play for fucking cheating.
Damn, cheater!
About that.
Don't cheat. Green Lantern and Space Ghost. Ghosts have a fucking crossover.
What?
Comic
book.
No,
Space
no.
Ghost, Coast
to Coast. It's not Coast to Coast. It's not Coast to Coast, Space Ghost.
That's the one I wanted.
That's the one everyone wants. It's just a fucking comic book of a talk show.
It's like, so what are you doing?
Green Lantern and Space Jordan. Ghost.
God damn it.
When I think I was in a group chat while that came out, like that popped up on my feed, and I was like, hey, you guys want to read a Green Lantern Space Ghost comic book? And Chase goes, Coast to Coast? I'm like, no, not Coast to Coast. It was a thing before Coast to Coast. But, Space Ghost.
Space Ghost?
Space Ghost got a good design.
God damn it, it's so good to say Coast to Coast after.
Coast to Coast, it does.
Coast to
Coast. It just fucking goes, Coast to Coast. Next up, these are sold out already.
Oh.
But, you can pre-order a $150 Widowmaker statue.
Yeah.
I don't have that kind of thing.
Looks,
how big is that?
I'll open it up here.
Yeah, I'll see. It probably looks pretty fucking dope, though. Like, I always
statue. It's not a... That's not from Endgame.
I always think about buying statues.
Let's pull this... Yeah, I do, too.
It better be as tall as me.
It looks like it's a good,
probably,
like, 8 inches.
Yeah.
My life-size Widowmaker.
Oh, what?
8 inches.
Well, you know what would be really cool? If the hair was, like... Not necessarily real, but like Barbie hair, kind of.
No.
Not plastic. Well, Barbie hair is technically plastic, but y'all get what I'm saying.
Yeah. But if you pre-ordered the Legendary Edition of Overwatch, you got a Tracer statue. And I assume it's around the same size, kind of.
Hand sculpted.
Yeah, they'd say
that. Yeah, hand sculpted.
It looks really nice.
Hand painted.
That would be a great birthday present.
13.5 inches.
That's way more than...
That's a tall-ass statue.
Yeah, that's pretty tall.
That's about the size, the height that fucking Titanfall helmet stands up.
Yeah, that's a good size statue.
That would
yeah,
be a great
that's a good
birthday
pose.
Present.
That's a good... Like, if ever there was a Widowmaker pose, that would be it.
Yeah.
I wonder if they do other ones.
They probably
will. Probably
will. So that would sold
if it's
out
Widowmaker,
already.
Yeah, like, I don't
yeah.
know.
Speaking
of all characters.
Speaking of Tracer... Somebody cosplay this
hair. Oh, yeah.
She-ha.
Yeah, Meg. It's Meg.
Yeah. She hot.
Yeah, she hot. Meg is hot.
That's what Meg does now.
That's more Destiny. We'll get to in a second.
Mama.
Telltale Guardians Galaxy release date.
Yeah.
I didn't even know they were making that.
Yeah, that got leaked a while
fucking
back.
Telltale's just throwing everything
and then,
there,
yeah.
Man.
Just anyone that will give them a license, they're making a game.
They're all going to be pretty good.
And guess what? First episode out April 18th.
That's the only thing that turns me off from Telltale games.
It's episodes.
Episodic.
Just give it all to
just,
me.
I'm, if it's episode, I'm not going to want to go back.
But that's like how a lot of... Well, yeah, if it's an episode, that's true. But that's how a lot of games are. DLCs.
Yeah, but you finish out the main story like, all right, I feel accomplished. This is like you get to a climax and then you gotta wait like 3 months or
yeah.
something.
Like Hitman, yeah, that's why I don't want to get... Hitman, because Hitman came out, and that's why...
Final Fantasy VII. Fuck that shit.
Yeah,
just
I
give
know.
Me a revamp for 7. Not this new bullshit.
On Destiny 2,
Destiny
we'll get to
2.
You.
That's the
Justice League trailer. Has everyone seen that?
Yeah.
Okay. It's, I mean, we get more...
Fuck.
You know who stands out in this fucking trailer? The Jason. Flash and Aquaman.
The only two that will, because they're new?
Yeah. And
Cyborg,
no one gives a shit.
Cyborg's
cool in Teen Titans.
Yeah, that's about it.
That's the only good iteration of Cyborg is Teen Titans.
I like Raven.
I like Raven in Teen Titans.
But they haven't put Raven anywhere else.
No, well, they put her in Injustice 1.
In the game?
Yeah, she all was right. a DLC. Because they had costume packs for her and a Cyborg.
Oh,
and Robin.
Okay. Gotcha.
Warped Tour's lineup was announced. If you want to go look at that, go look at it. There's way too many bands. Highlights are Bowling for Soup and
Goldfinger.
Yeah.
Bowling for Soup?
Bowling for Soup.
She does that every time. I'm trying to... CKY for CKY people. Watsky. Fast rapping guy, Beartooth,
Silverstein,
popular, Silverstein, Neck Deep, Dance Gavin Dance, Memphis Mayfire.
Hatebreed. And I can get Brian to go now.
Bless the Fall.
Brian.
Guar.
Naked Walrus. I don't even know how these bands, but they sound funny.
Anti-Flag.
Bad Cop.
What's her name on Comedy Central?
Do what?
Sarah Silverman.
Sarah Silverman.
Yeah. And we can get Brian to go with us. I just got to tell them they got Dance Gavin Dance. That boy loves it.
They're pretty good.
They are. I can't give them the credit.
Yeah, that's like...
The Gospel Youth?
The Gospel
Youth. Suicide Machines are good. Suicide Machines are an old funk band.
I Fight Dragons, thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic
man.
Plastics.
I could go for another I Fight Dragons.
That's good.
But
never shall never.
Check your dates for when if you want to go.
Fuck, that's what I need to apply for.
Australia, before we get to the next thing, Australia found a dinosaur footprint that is like 6.5 feet long.
Yeah.
So, big ass fucking sauropod, for sure. You know your dinosaurs, you know, you got what I'm saying.
Get out of here.
Chance the Rapper needs an intern.
Yo, Chance, hit me up.
Why does he need an intern?
I don't know, but I'll write some dirty rap songs with them.
I read this article, and I can't quite remember what it said.
I sing all them Cocoa Butter Kisses.
putting together decks and writing proposals.
I can do that.
So, if you feel like you are, if you feel like you're qualified, Chance the Rapper needs an intern.
Qualify for me.
Back to crazy science, man. Elon Musk wants to attach people's brains to computers.
Get that Matrix shit out of here.
I was gonna say Matrix and Soma.
Yeah.
Both of which are terrifying futures. But he thinks we're already living in a Matrix. So.
Yeah, he does. He said he had scientific proof. I didn't read that.
Yeah. So
I don't want to know.
So if you want to be a robot, you can upload your consciousness to Elon Musk's hard drive.
Can't start fucking flying.
Plus, because when he gets out, he's just in another layer of the Matrix.
Sure.
The Matrix is too deep.
Because they got to make him feel like they win, so they get you're good.
Spider-Man Homecoming, new trailer out. Looks nice. He fights with Iron Man a little bit. It's almost looking like Iron Man 4 at this point.
Yeah.
With the amount of Iron Man that's in this trailer, it seems like Iron Man is going to be a predominant character throughout this thing.
Well, he got that big old hug from Tony and that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you give him a hug.
Yeah, he goes in for the hug. He's,
well, he hugs him, and he's just like,
I didn't know about the car scene. Or he's actually just trying to get the door, but he goes to hug him. He's like, I'm getting the door for you, kid.
Laser Team 2 has begun production.
Nice.
And we got a couple castings. I can't remember where they're from. There are people that have been in stuff, but not like major actors or anything.
I saw one.
Superstore, who Colton, who's in Laser Team 1, he's Boot Crew, is going to be one of the characters from that is going to be in that. And then another lady from Heartland.
What the fuck is that?
Some Bitch Lord?
Bitch Lord. Gavin Free?
Yeah.
Some Bitch Lord named Gavin Free. It trailer came out.
Oh, saw that. Looks pretty good.
Man, so I see that trailer and then we went to my mom's. When did we go to my mom's?
Yesterday and the day before.
Yeah. Day before yesterday. And she has it, so I just ended up watching it. That movie is long as fuck.
Yeah. It's because it was a series.
Even on the DVD, yeah. Like, VHS, I knew it was, but even the DVD, like, the one she got, you had to, like, flip it over.
Oh, yeah.
Just like the old, like, the VHS, you had to, like, play it. You know? So I was like, damn.
It's going to be part one.
No, just part one of it right now?
Yeah, that's what the trailer's for, part one.
Because it's just the when they're kids bit.
Oh, yeah.
And then the second part will be when they're adults, because it hibernates for 30 years or whatever.
Yeah.
And it comes some giant fucking spider bullshit. Yeah. Spoiler alert if you haven't seen the 40-year-old movie.
Or read the
won't be a stupid spider this time.
It'll just be Tim Curry.
It looks like shit.
Yeah.
That part of the movie, it's all good until it gets that CGI looking shit. And I'm like, God.
From the book, too, where they just started fucking.
Yeah.
and then they just killed the spider thing. They ripped its head off.
Oh, yeah. They start trying to fight it. Yeah. That movie's pretty... They'll take a different adaptation, because I watched the old one literally like a day or two ago. And it's kind of corny. Some parts of it. You know how, like, when the stomach of it shows and it's really bright and it kind of just, like, you get stuck looking at it?
Yeah.
And, like, three of them run down there like, hey, man, what's going... And then another one doesn't. I'm like, all right, you guys can stop this now.
Sony is giving out golden tickets worth $100 to random people on PlayStation.
Nice.
So
give me them get your golden tickets to the Willy Wonka.
Yeah, go hang out at the Sony's chocolate factory.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's full of shit.
Full of shit.
No man's chest. Here's a real interesting one.
I want to start watching that.
Betting on Rocket League tournaments.
I want to see Pro Rocket League. Because I bet you it's like...
legal in Vegas.
Yeah, but can we do it? If it's hosted in Vegas?
Maybe. I don't know exactly how this will work.
Speaking of that, it's just a random thing. On the radio, I heard there's an ad for tried and legalized sports betting in America.
In Australia, in time for season 3. It'll be available in Australia. They said Seattle, Berlin, and Sydney.
Psyonix does not support or endorse online betting for their game, but it's another company called Unikern.
Unikern.
That's gonna be in charge of all that. They also do CS:GO betting.
Fuck off.
That's why Valve said fuck off with that.
Yeah.
But then there was a whole bunch of other shit that happened with that CSGO stuff.
Yeah.
Because they found out that a guy that was betting on the site actually owned the fucking site.
Yeah, I remember.
A bunch of those guys did.
There's a Ghostbusters VR game coming out for PS4.
Whoa.
I think it came out already by the time this is getting seen.
Thank God.
But yeah, Ghostbusters VR.
Probably gonna be terrible.
Yeah, I'm looking like a little picture of Slimer that we can see.
Yeah.
Don't look great.
Don't look great. Oh, here we go.
Maybe
this will be better.
It can't be worse. Yeah. Assassin's Creed's getting a TV show confirmed by Ubisoft, which is all right. I'm gonna open that up.
I need to buy one of those and give it to Brian. That's immediately what he sends me on Steam when I get on. It's just kind of annoying.
Solar.
Yeah, solar.
But moving on a little bit.
For all you Sunbro lovers.
Another statue. Fucking Solaire, big ass statue. I love the fucking face.
Yeah. Fucking Solaire is slick. OPS dude.
Yeah, yeah, Sir Darkseid's one.
Regular edition Solaire. Available for pre-order now. $294.99.
And it includes the character. The exclusive edition is available for $355. Includes a shield die. If you want to pay $345, you get the shield, die-cast sword, interchangeable bases, and other accessories.
Found Dark Souls. That's what them Dark Souls are.
So who? You want to?
But he's praising the sun, motherfucker.
Is that in the game?
Oh
no, that's the statue.
It looks like
it's in the game, but it's a statue. Yeah, the statue like plastered in the game.
I figured maybe you got something where you could like put it down in the game.
Oh, that'd be kind of cool.
But Solaire holds a very, very
special place.
Extreme cult following, among Dark Souls people.
Kind of went over the.
Yeah, Black Adam. Black Adam's announced for Injustice. He's Black Adam. I have to assume because of that, we'll also get Shazam.
Shazam.
Which they're doing that Black Adam movie still, starring The Rock.
I forget about that.
Yeah. Because it's not in the DC Cinematic Universe.
Oh, another hot topic.
Man, those For Honor players, man. They want that game to be something that Ubisoft doesn't want it to be.
Stop.
Yeah, that's
making
the protest
gear
bits about.
Doesn't matter playlist, not play that game.
Yeah,
again.
Yeah, make a playlist where your gear level doesn't matter.
Call
I'm
it to get, just get good.
That's...
Yeah.
How?
I'm not gonna go in there and hang out and get
one
shot
and then the other dude I'm fighting gets revenge every 4 seconds.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Because they paid $600 for their gear. Dark Souls 3's fucking DLC's out. We covered that. GameStop expects Nintendo Switch shortages to continue all year.
Yeah.
Nice.
I saw another picture. I don't know if I saved it. But it's of it was Mario and people dressed in like Mario and Luigi costumes. It's like, we're working hard to get new Switches shipped out to you guys. New shipments should be coming in soon. And it's like, and somebody replied to it, it's like, that's the problem. They got two fucking guys shipping out all the Switches.
Goddamn.
But for a sign up for the Switch, they beat PS4 sales in their first 4 weeks compared to PS4.
Yeah.
So it's in Japan, at least.
Yeah.
They sold like 540,000 units.
Yeah.
Which is pretty good, but still didn't beat the Wii U.
Yeah.
The Wii U had like a fucking crazy amount.
Yeah, Wii U launched real hard and then fucking dropped off.
It launched way better in Japan than it did over
here. Yeah, nobody gave a shit here because it was just, everyone thought it was just an add-on to the Wii.
Which
yeah,
essentially it was.
Which it essentially was, but it was,
and then they,
it was a
then they brought
$250
the Switch,
version.
Which is like, here's your Wii U and your Wii
yeah,
in one.
Yeah, pretty much.
Outlast 2 is no longer banned in Australia.
They took
it
out that crazy rape scene, I bet.
Yeah, I bet so. So, the tagline is
yeah,
nightmares for everyone.
Nice.
So, if you're...
It'll be one of those... it's like old games, like, when people do speedruns, they buy, like, certain copies, like a Japan copy of...
Yada yada.
Yeah, yeah, that game, just because there's that part in it and this part doesn't have it. So
yeah,
I'm
they'll just import it.
Australia.
Anything.
And it's smart move for Outlast. Too,
yeah,
develop it just so they get more sales.
Well, it's like I've got a PS4 game, it's a Japanese game, but it's all subtitled and all the menus are in English.
Yeah.
So it's like, okay, I'll just play it in English.
Yeah, because they know
I can't get the DLC because I don't have I think it's a Singapore account that you have to have.
Yeah.
That's weird.
But I was like, alright, fucking, I just won't get the DLC.
It's all English because they know us. Why do you like our Gundam, too?
We do like our Gundam. Ukulele drops the bird himself, Jontron.
Shit.
Following the controversy of all his fucking racist shit, he said.
Man.
Right.
So.
They don't fly anymore.
Jontron and feuds.
Yep, they gonna hang out in the racist boat.
James don't give a shit because he's rich as shit.
Yeah.
Jontron's probably got a good amount of money.
Jontron's got a good amount. He got some early Game Grumps money, and that just set him on his course.
Yeah, but no one will match Pewds.
No one will match Pewds. That's Call of Duty thing again. Gladio again. I say multiple of these because I forget.
Some Nintendo Switch games could be played vertically.
There are going to be... Because somebody hacked into it already. And found out that there are settings for the vertical setting for games. So there's gonna be upright fucking Switch games, I guess.
It's cool.
I don't know what game.
Yeah,
games would be like that.
The only game that I thought of that is upright is the one we talked about like last podcast where you rub the girls and their clothes come off for PS Vita. That's the only game that came to mind when I thought of that.
Good shit.
It's coming out on Steam. We're going to play it for Anime Trash.
Switch ain't getting that, though. Nintendo's like, no.
They got Binding of Isaac. As
we're taking it. Tony Mega.
That'll forever be fucking funny to me. Goddamn.
The only mature game out on the Switch right now is Binding of Isaac.
It's just mature because of...
It's already starting, boys.
Yeah.
Get them shiny Magikarps.
You missed out because that shit.
That water
happened.
Event's gone, so you can just go fucking farm your Magikarps at your local nest.
Fucking.
I hope you get one.
I wonder what the spawn rate.
Not great.
I caught probably a good 50 to 100 Magikarps.
Yeah.
No shiny
spawn rate, like, normally. Good luck.
Yeah.
They're rare, and then if you get to certain spots, like that park that me and Casey go to and stuff, they're everywhere there, but that's just because it's a nest.
Yeah.
But still, like, catching a shiny, that's got to even make it, like...
That's even harder.
If it's anything close to the game...
And I don't even know if it changed the rate of it being from the water event to now.
Yeah.
So I don't know if it's, like, there was more chance
of getting
a shiny.
I think you just had a better chance of catching it during the water event because there were
more
spawning just all over the place.
Yeah.
They increased the shiny rate from...
Point Heroes something
from like the old games to the more modern like 3DS
it was
ones.
One in 8,000 to one in like 6,000 or
something like that. They increased it by a good bit for those kind of odds anyway.
Yeah,
it was like, so if you play like three Pokemon games, odds are you might see one shiny.
Yeah.
I don't know how much you play too.
That's like playing
the literal campaign. Only the literal only shiny I've ever gotten since playing Pokemon from the beginning is that red Gyarados that they give you.
Yeah.
I've got
that's everybody's.
I think it. Shiny Butterfree.
Yeah.
And I think one more, but I can't remember. It's from the old Pokemon, so I haven't got anything past Pearl.
Yeah.
Shiny, I know for sure. And that's like five games, no shinies.
Yeah, seriously. GameStop's closing over 150 stores due to poor holiday 2016 sales.
Ooh.
Because Amazon exists.
Yeah.
And
games are still digital now.
Yeah, digital.
And there's no point in taking them back at this point.
No.
Because nobody gives you... Well, there's some little stores that might give you more, but GameStop doesn't give you shit.
Yeah, Mom and Pops might give you something for...
Yeah, but...
But
now it's...
Nobody gives a shit about my copy of Far Cry 3.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're gonna take that to GameStop. They're gonna give
you won't even get $5.
80 cents for it, and they're gonna sell it for $15.
I got $1.50 for Bulletstorm, and then went in the next week, and my copy was on sale for $15.
Yeah, I did one of my what was it? I forgot what it was, but yeah, I remember seeing one of my games because it had a certain case on it that was different than all the other ones, and it was like a week or two after, and I saw it. And I was like, man, y'all don't even give me half of that.
But speaking of them,
but I'm sure poorly, those stores are just like in poor
places.
They're
already doing poorly. Yeah.
Yeah. The area
just
they're in
kind of put them over the edge.
Yeah.
But I think Microsoft shot out an idea. They just put it on Twitter. They didn't say they were going to do anything. It's like, how would you guys feel for the next console to be have no disc drive?
Yeah.
And immediately everyone said, no, we want the disc drive.
Well, it's because you.
I don't like mine now. Like, mine's already being funky with mine, so...
The only
only
reason to have a disc drive is to play movies.
It's to play movies and to take your games to GameStop when you're done playing them.
Yeah. Well,
that's for those guys that do that, though.
Yeah. Or anyone that has GameFly kind of thing.
Which...
You still use
now,
it. Like,
with all
I still,
new things,
like, I've never met anybody that knows, like... I've never used it, and I still know anybody
Chase was
that
the
GameFly.
Only person that... He was the last person to use GameFly. And that's because Todd had it,
But, because they're opening all these things like that Microsoft Steam thing, or you can play all those games for $10 a month. It's GameFly, but you can pick what games you want all the time. You don't have to send a game out.
It's kind of like a Netflix, but instead of picking a movie to watch, you just start up a game.
Yeah.
No,
I wonder if you still have to download the game, though.
Yeah, probably.
That's got to bite the dick. That's the only reason I buy digital now, like... Don't get me wrong, like, with the whole Destiny 2 situation, like, I want all that physical bullshit you can give me, and I like midnight launches, but I don't want to go stay up till midnight there, get my copy, then run home and put it in and wait for it to download.
And
I want my shit to be ready, and then just bam.
Because it's got
to
download Destiny 2.
Yeah. And then when it starts, when they release the game, then you got to get it up.
Yeah.
And please, dear Lord, for even getting this Destiny 2, do not do what you did with Rise of Iron, where you just let people in.
Yeah.
Even though they probably will, because there'd be a fuck ton of people just waiting to play a game.
Dude, like, and the thing is, though, you're gonna have to, if you get the disc, you're gonna have to download it anyway. And it's 70 gigs!
Yeah.
We're gonna get in Destiny in just a minute, because we're almost done with this fucking thing. But X-Men's new series, Gifted, is gonna be on Fox, I believe, or FX, or a Fox affiliate, because that's who owns it. They've got production photos, not really showing off a whole lot, don't know what characters... There's also some stuff about the Inhumans, but nobody fucking knows about the Inhumans but me.
no, we already talked about that.
Call of Duty talked about Funimation has acquired the rights to dub Berserk. The most recent animated series, which was alright.
Dark Souls in an anime, pretty much.
You want to see some gory shit?
Dark Souls is all about Berserk.
Yeah.
That
he can pretty much get his arm
around. He fucking loves Berserk. Speedrunner beats Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild in under 50 minutes.
Of course, because you can... Once you get good enough, you just streamline to Master Sword, I guess, so you can kill Ganon and then beat Ganon.
Yeah.
Just by being good.
And then the last thing here that we actually have that's pertinent is... And they'll be the show's face glitches.
Dear Lord.
I'm gonna open this up.
Oh, that one makes me sick, dude. That one makes me sick.
I'm gonna see if I can open it up on. I'm gonna see if I can open it up on this for you guys to see.
It bothers me just because there's two eyes there.
That would cause kids nightmares.
Look at the one to the left.
It just looks like a butthole.
It just looks like a bunch of hair.
Basically, what's going on is their faces are just inverted. So the outside is in.
I don't even know what the one on the right is.
I don't know what the
one on the left looks like a helmet with a bunch of hair. Yeah. Ugh.
Let me I know how I can do this.
Graphical improvements.
So I want this to be seen.
You want everyone to see the fucking monsters. Yeah.
See these fucking, the one on the left looks like a butthole.
It does.
That hairy hole.
Maybe that's what they did. Instead of putting your face, they just put their butthole right there.
Oh man, that'd be the greatest paw.
Let me see if I can get it to. There we go. Look at this nightmare.
Oh god.
What is that? Why would anyone?
Get that out.
How does that happen? All right, I'm getting that out of there.
Well, those things have always been bad. Like the last couple NBA games, they ain't been that bad, but they've been pretty bad.
The first one was real rough.
Yeah.
Using the old Kinect.
Yeah, the old Kinect. Yeah.
I did not like it.
No, it did not.
But
they tried. They tried.
Yeah, no, it was. Oh,
one day we'll be able to just perfectly scan our faces and.
Yeah. And I won't look like a fucking orangutan when I do it.
Something like that.
DBZ related.
Yeah. Dragon Ball.
They have a live action series going on right now that fans are making.
Alright.
Going on looks like garbage. And that's
we're getting to the last like 10 minutes.
That's it for news stuff.
Light of hope.
Except for my sick teriyaki chicken pineapple bowl.
Yeah, damn, we talked about that last time.
You better make that shit.
I'm gonna make that shit. I gotta go to the grocery store though.
I'll eat 50 of them.
50 of them? We bought some
wonton. Just do a quick check real quick, make sure nothing new. Oh, it's April Fool's, so watch yourself.
Yeah.
Maybe none of anything we said today was true.
Oh man.
Or maybe it was all true, because the biggest con is telling the truth on the internet.
WrestleMania is going on.
Is it?
I think it's happening this weekend.
Fuck. You want to pay $80 to see Goldberg kick the shit out of someone?
In like 20 seconds?
Before he has a
just
fucking heart attack?
Break somebody in half and fucking spears him for the last time?
Yeah, that looks like all the stuff that I can find here.
Did you guys ever see that magazine cover with that fucking dude?
No,
dude.
I don't think I did.
Pull it up real quick. I just want you guys to see how ridiculous it looks.
Shit, what's his name?
Fuck yeah, just do
Elon.
It's not Elon.
No, it's not Elon.
Palmer
Lucky.
Palmer Lucky.
Yeah, that's right.
I was saying Luck. I was like, I think Lucky Ted does, but that's not. That's not right. Palmer Lucky magazine. There we go.
Magazine code.
Oh man,
this thing's a gem. It's got so many fucking...
Jesus fucking Christ.
That's the future.
That's a Time magazine cover?
Oh, yeah, that's an actual cover. Look up
Time magazine Palmer Lucky. And you'll see what we're fucking laughing about.
And you'll see a bunch of memes of it.
No,
he's riding that T-Rex.
Jesus. Oh man. They went
to go down.
They went to town on it.
Oh my god, he's getting RKO'd.
Oh my god, there's so much.
That's just shooting stars.
That was
with
him
on here.
Putin. The
yeah, him with Putin on the horse.
That's a recent.
Gee, X-Men. Fucking cow. They went to town on that one.
Oh yeah. Oh, yeah. The stuff like that, though, is easy.
Oh,
it's like Tony Hawk's downhill jam, but they put him on a skateboard in the background.
Oh, yeah, didn't he have shoes on?
Oh man.
Who is that?
That's the dude.
Is that
made
him?
Oculus.
Is that him?
Yeah, it's the guy.
Okay.
It's the guy that did Oculus.
The Oculus company.
That will about do it for the Board Nerds Hour.
Not yet.
Huh? Not yet.
Not yet.
Oh yeah, shit. We got all this Destiny to talk about.
Are we already at now?
We are already at an hour 15.
We could do a Destiny podcast.
Man, we probably could. It probably would be an hour podcast.
Yeah. We could do like a
separate little thing for it. Yeah, okay.
Might as well.
So, thank you guys so much for...
We tricked you, April Fools! This is the last of it! Put the meme up!
We gotta put this movie out! We gotta put this video out today for it to make sense.
God. Thank you guys so much. You can follow us at the links that are up there. Yeah.
Yeah, because stage left and stage right.
Yeah. Fucking there. No! Nice! Thank you guys so much for watching. Follow us on all social media. Tell your friends. All that good stuff. We will see you if you're on Twitch with us in just a minute, where we talk about Destiny for
lots and lots forever. Of Destiny.
And then we will be doing a special anime cast, which is going to be...
Did we have a name for it yet?
Right now, the name is the Anime Trash Cast.
Anime Trash Cast.
Because the show we do is Anime Trash.
Yeah, okay, gotcha.
Yeah. But see you guys next time. Bye!
Bye!
Almost. Yeah.